CBS College Basketball returns with two of the winningest teams of all time, Kentucky and North Carolina. 12 combined national titles and traditions that go back generations. Michael Jordan. Today, it's new fresh faces that hope to add to the legacies of these two rich programs, as new memories are ready to be created.
Takes the shot. Oh, Indiana wins the championship.
Duke has done it. Duke has upset UNLV.
Leitner puts it up.
Yes! North Carolina is the 1993 national champion. Arkansas is in home heaven.
Edney going the distance.
Yes! Back door. Oh, yes!
Drew for the win.
Gone!
He did it!
Just when people say you can't, you can. There is a new dean in college basketball. Back to back and unforgettable.
Chalmers for the tie.
Get at it! In 2 seconds.
At midcourt, launches the shot.
Oh, it almost went in!
CBS Sports' 30th road to the Final Four begins now. From the Dean Dome on the campus of the University of North Carolina, this is NCAA Men's Basketball on CBS, presented by State Farm, where it's the 10th-ranked Kentucky Wildcats taking on the Tar Heels of North Carolina. Hi, everybody. I'm Gus Johnson, along with Clark Kellogg, and welcome to the season premiere of college basketball on CBS. And today we get an opportunity to see two story programs, and what makes it even more special, Clark, two story programs with some budding young stars.
Without question, Gus, you're looking at 4,035 combined wins between these programs, and one of the premier freshmen in all of college basketball, Terrence Jones. He has splashed onto the scene in tremendous fashion, 21 points a game, over 10 boards a game. He does it with force as well as finesse. He's a hard matchup for everybody.
And for North Carolina, they've struggled a bit starting this season.
Well, I spoke to Roy Williams just a moment ago. He knows his team has to play better. They've been close in a number of those losses, but just haven't been able to get over the hump. And if it's going to happen, they'll need their outstanding freshman, Harrison Barnes, to allow his multifaceted game to come to the forefront. There's not anything he can't do on the floor, Gus, but he's basically been overanalyzing things in a quest for perfection. He's just got to relax and play his game.
And that brings us to today's AT&T in-game analysis.
Well, for both teams, they're going to look to play with physicality and force. To me, that indicates let's keep an eye on the free throw game both ways. Carolina has really struggled making shots. They've gotten good shots. They need to knock down some perimeter jump shots. And then both teams, because they're young, Kentucky being on the road, North Carolina's had trouble with turnovers all season. Both teams need to take care of the ball and squeeze the pumpkin.
So coming up from Tobacco Road, North Carolina, Kentucky, college basketball, CBS.
CBS Sports College Basketball coverage is sponsored by the Lexus December to Remember sales event, now for a limited time at your Lexus dealer. And by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go.
Welcome back to the Dean Dome here on the campus of the University of North Carolina. We are ready for college basketball. We'll start with the 5-1 Kentucky Wildcats.
Brandon Knight, the outstanding freshman, has scored 20-plus points in two of his last three games and is continuing to grow as a point guard running this team. Terrence Jones, the outstanding freshman, posting 20-plus points and over 10 rebounds a game. Josh Harrelson 26 offensive rebounds already.
And for North Carolina,
Larry Drew II has really struggled shooting the ball, 22% shooting, but he's been excellent at the defensive end of the floor.
And in the front court,
you've got Tyler Zeller, has to avoid foul trouble because if he can stay on the floor 30-plus minutes, he's a real factor down low.
So John Calipari, the head coach of the Kentucky Wildcats, his team 35-3 last year. He's only in his second season after spending such quality time at the University of Memphis. Prior to that, UMass. And Roy Williams, one of the deans of coaching in all of college basketball, Hall of Famer, two-time national champion in his eighth season. And he's trying to come up with the right combination to ignite his young and very talented team.
Well, I had a chance to visit with him just before the start of today's game, Gus, and he talked about thinking, knowing that his team is going to get better. They've got to get some shots to go down early, and they need perimeter shooting from their backcourt.
And we're underway, the season premiere of college basketball on CBS, and North Carolina controls the tip. They feed Henson early. He draws a double team. Strickland, 16 off the heel. Batted around and picked up by Terrence Jones. What do you expect to see in this game in terms of tempo?
Well, I think it'll be a fast-paced game. You know, Roy Williams' teams always want to get out and run, and when they can defensive rebound, this is what you can expect to see, a quick push ahead and trying to score early in the offense.
Strickland, the very shifty point guard out of Rahway, New Jersey. That ball out of bounds, no, safe from going out of bounds by Darius Miller. So Kentucky's coming off a 91-57 win over Boston University in Lexington. Miller knocks down a triple, and the Wildcats are on the board. Kentucky playing their fifth game on the road in their last six, so they're battle-tested, played in the Maui Invitational. Some very competitive games out there. Zeller steps out and hits a 15-footer.
Without question, but this is a true road game for Kentucky. Maui, the competition was very good, but that's a neutral court. This is a real home court advantage here for North Carolina. And because they're at home, I think this young team will play one of its best games of the early season.
Jones posting up, trying to fend off Henson. Hits it with a nice rebound. He moved to power forward last year, and it really changed his game. He's a good shot blocker and a good offensive rebound. And a foul inside.
That's an excellent point you make, Gus. He came in, and Roy Williams and John Henson thought he might be effective as a three-man. Didn't quite work out. He's so active around the goal. He's long, he's wiry, he's springy, and he's got good hands and a nice touch. So he's much better in a 10 to 12-foot operating area as opposed to on the wing.
Ball lobbed in, stolen away by Harrelson. Turnovers have been a problem for North Carolina this year as Knight uses his strength and banks one in. Strickland lost the handle. Liggins hits the deck, and the possession arrow favors Kentucky. North Carolina on the season, Clark, averaging 17 turnovers per game. They're forcing only 16.
That's a problem. And you saw right there, that turnover created, though, Gus, because the wingmen did not run wide. They were too close together. I call that being braked up. You want to run wide and space the floor so you have better passing angle.
5-2 Kentucky. Kentucky's played some very, very stiff competition on the season. Great game in Maui against Washington, and they also lost their only game of the season to Connecticut. How about Connecticut, Clark, out of nowhere, going from unranked to in the top 10?
Well, they played exceptionally well so far, and Kemba Walker, your early leading candidate for player of the year. He had a triple-double last night, and has averaged close to 30 points a game this season. Not only has he produced numbers, but he's also provided great leadership for that UConn club.
Henson picks up the foul. That's his first. Knight, the point guard from Florida, baseline jump shot. And that one's off the mark for Lamb. Loose ball. And here comes Drew in transition. Nice look, Henson. Bang.
Henson for the basket. That's by Henson.
5-4 Kentucky. Miller off the dribble. These two teams facing each other for the 11th consecutive season. Kentucky beating North Carolina last year in Lexington, 68-66. Baseline, Harrelson, power dribble, and that's an offensive foul. North Carolina getting out in transition.
And when you're struggling to make perimeter shots, get easy opportunities before the defense is set. Miscommunication defensively. Good keeping the dribble alive by Drew the second. And then Henson finds himself alone at the rim. So well done by Carolina.
So Josh Harrelson picks up his second foul. He heads to the bench. Harrelson, the junior college transfer. And now they bring in Eloy Vargas, a junior from the Dominican Republic. He wears number 30, originally a Florida transfer, now at Kentucky. Drew the lob. Henson going up high.
Boy, nice execution almost, but a good look. And Henson very active here early. I thought he was terrific in the loss at Illinois, particularly in the first half. I just liked his energy level and his activity. Got his hands on a lot of rebounds and finished inside when he had opportunities.
John Henson, you're right, at 16 points on 8 of 11 shooting. 6 rebounds in the game against Illinois. Carolina falling to the Fighting Illini, 79-67. Illinois ranked in the top 20. Henson knocks down the second, and Carolina up by a penny. Pick and roll, Knight. Vargas steps out, 12-footer. That ball rebounded by Strickland. Drew, rise and fire.
Those are the kinds of shots you like to get in transition that need to go down for this young Carolina team. I really think there are a few perimeter shots made from having a lot of confidence, because they're doing a good job at this end of the floor, Gus. The defense has been solid.
Nice block by Henson. Carolina again. And this is what we saw yesterday in practice, Clark. They were going up and down for a good 45 minutes. Barnes. And what I liked about what coach did yesterday, they were going up and down, and when things would happen, he would stop practice, but he allowed them to be fluid yesterday.
Oh, he wants to see them run. You take a look at Harrison Barnes. His first two games, he put up strong numbers. In the last five, he's gone south. Some of that has been him pressing. He's got kind of a perfectionist personality when you talk to the people here around the North Carolina program, and part of his desire to do well has been putting too much pressure on himself. He's got to let up and let go.
Jones off the mark. Barnes with the rebound. Outlet pass. Inside Zeller. Nice move. He's got all those little things you like down there. Jump hooks. Teardrops. Nice soft touch. For the man from Washington, Indiana, 15:40 to play. First half, Tar Heels up 8-5.
Take a look at the states that have the most championships. No surprise, California leads the way with 15, all of those for UCLA under the late John Wood. Kentucky with 9, and then North Carolina in second place there with 11, and 9 of those between Duke and North Carolina.
Duke looked really good the other night against Michigan State.
They're playing at a really high level for this early in the season, Gus. And you attribute that to the bench leadership, but also excellent seniors in Singler and Smith.
That ball deflected. Kentucky will hold on. 15:41 to play, first half. 8-5. Back to Chapel Hill after this.
Baby, you're a firework. Come on, let your go.
Well, Clark, Kris Kringle is getting ready to make his mad dash around the world, and let's take a look at the holiday wish list presented by Sears.
Well, at my house, we call them stocking stuffers, and we're going to look at North Carolina. Physicality potion. They need to get stronger, play tougher, play meaner. Barnes blossoms. Harrison Barnes relaxes and plays his game. And then finally, turnover valves for North Carolina. They've got to turn off the turnovers.
And when we were watching practice yesterday with Kentucky, John Calipari, really, really specific with this team about how he wanted to go at North Carolina.
He wanted to be physical, wanted to get up under their chin defensively, wanted to attack them in the paint area. North Carolina on the 6-0 run over the last 2 minutes. This kid has a terrific stroke. That's Brandon Knight. He can really shoot it. A
excellent form, balance, and follow-through.
Average 33 points a game at Pinecrest High School. Here's a steal, straight to the bucket, and a jam for DeAndre Liggins, the junior out of the Windy City.
Maybe we need to give that turnover valve to North Carolina before Christmas.
Drew kicks it out. Strickland got it. Dexter Strickland. We saw him. He was the first player on the court yesterday before practice, and he was working on that jump shot right there.
Well, he knows those are the kinds of shots he has to make, and he'll get them in the flow of Carolina's offense.
Deron Lamb, the freshman out of Queens, New York, with the floater on the baseline, 12-10. Kentucky, so many talented players on both these teams.
You're right.
And they're babies.
They're young fellas, but they've got game.
Ah, high off the window. Game tied at 12. Great pace to start. Season opener. 30 years of college basketball on CBS. We've got Kentucky and UNC. Baseline off the heel. Barnes with the rebound. North Carolina with numbers. Zeller. Cross the lane. And Darius Miller hauls it down. Knight the other way. And draws contact. Your officials today, Roger Ayers, Mike Eads, and Jamie Lucky. And that foul call on Drew. That's his first.
John Vincent's back for Carolina.
So it's a non-shooting foul. Kentucky inbounding. Jones, Knight, Miller, along with Vargas. And Lamb on the court. Now Lamb backs it up. Very versatile. 6'4 guard. Can run the point. Pick and roll. Jones across the lane. Lefty. Knocked out of bounds, and we'll head the other way.
You know, Kentucky not a very deep team. With Harrelson picking up his second foul a couple of minutes ago, a seven-man rotation really becomes six for John Calipari. North Carolina, on the other hand, will play nine guys, double-digit minutes, maybe even 10. They've got an advantage there as long as the second unit is productive.
That's Kendall Marshall, number five, with the basketball. Bullock straight away. Rims off. Vargas with the rebound.
Well, I tell you what, I like the quality of shots that North Carolina has been able to get in its offense.
And
that's a pretty high-quality quick trigger right there. As Knight comes right back at him after the missed Carolina shot. Puts an awful lot of pressure on North Carolina's defense in transition.
Kendall Marshall picking up his first, and that sends Knight to the line. It was very interesting talking to John Calipari yesterday at practice, and he was talking about Brandon Knight and how his parents had to step in and give him some words of wisdom, which Coach Calipari just loved.
He appreciated it because so oftentimes with young players, those in their inner circle may not be saying the same things that the coaches are about their performance and what needs to be done. But after a difficult outing against UConn, as we see, Justin Knox getting to the rim with force. But his parents talked about what he needed to do better and what he needed to pay attention to after a subpar performance. And Coach Cal appreciated the added voices in Brandon Knight's ear.
Ephraim and Tanya, his parents. Now Marshall. Inside. Strip. Picked up. Lamb. Splits the defense. Down the lane and draws a foul. And he gives McDonald a nice elbow going out of bounds.
Good attack of the rim and pretty good ball handling there by Lamb. And we couldn't see it from that angle, but you're right, there was a bit of a mild chicken wing applied by Lamb to McDonald after the guys got to the end of the play. Here you take a look, then watch the left arm right there. Just incidental love tap. Just a little kind of nothing. You want to jump on top of that, though, so it doesn't escalate beyond that. Certainly not what you want to see from Lamb, but it doesn't warrant anything in my mind other than a warning.
McDonald picked up his first. Lamb gets the free throw to go. Kentucky shooting 61% from the free throw line as a team. And Coach Calipari, he wasn't upset with the way his team has been shooting free throws, but he definitely wants them to get better.
And he feels like the guys have the shooting form and technique. It's now a matter of emphasizing it and concentrating, particularly in practice. You've got good form and good mechanics. You should make 70% or more of your foul shots.
A lot of freshmen. Henson, jump hook left hand. Loose, Bullock trying to grab it and out of bounds. 11:54 to play in the first half. Competitive so far. Kentucky up by a deuce.
CBS Sports College basketball coverage is sponsored by State Farm. With 18,000 agents, we've got the best lineup in the game.
Welcome back to Chapel Hill. Let's take a look at some of the headlines. How about UConn?
Kemba Walker leading that young team to a top 10 ranking after starting the season unranked. And you take a look at the Big Ten ACC Challenge. The Big Ten prevails for the second year in a row. Man, how about Marcus Jordan and the University of Central Florida knocking off the Florida Gators? Jordan was the team high 18 in that one.
Michael Jordan's son, as a matter of fact. Michael getting ready to go in the North Carolina Hall of Fame.
Well, there isn't any basketball Hall of Fame that he shouldn't be in.
16-14 Kentucky. Wildcats, 5 of 13 from the field, 39%. Liggins, baseline, Lamb gathers himself. Nice shot.
He's giving him a nice boost off the bench. That's 7 points for him now. He gives you everything, Gus. A multifaceted game. He can handle it. He can defend. He can get you off the dribble. He's just catch and shoot guy. Terrific asset to have a score like that coming off the bench.
Meanwhile, foul coming up. And this will go against North Carolina, and Knox picked up his first. But this kid here, Terrence Jones, we were having an opportunity to watch him practice yesterday, and Coach Calipari writing him about his free throws. But just a little nitpick, because when you're a freshman averaging a double-double, I think you're doing okay.
Without question. Not just a double-double, a 2010 double-double. That's rarefied air for any player, let alone a first-year guy.
Jones coming off an 18-point, 10-rebound game. Liggins, he's been working on that jump shot, and that one was pure. Well, Kentucky on a 7-0 run.
Well, they knocked down a bunch of threes in their last game against Boston University. Made 10 of 16 from behind the arc, so this is a very capable team from three-point land.
Barnes dips inside, double clutch, and draws a foul. That's Liggins. So a tough draw for Harrison Barnes being guarded by, as a freshman, being guarded by very strong athletic junior in DeAndre Liggins.
That's exactly right, and Liggins, an excellent defender. That time he just got a little anxious, left his feet, and Barnes forced him to commit the foul.
So Harrison from Ames, Iowa. The Sporting News 2010 National High School Player of the Year. The USA Today National Player of the Year. Play for Vance Downs at Ames High School. Second one in and out. And tracked down by Terrence Jones.
Well, Terrence Jones yet to score, and Kentucky has found its way to a 6-point lead thanks to the good shooting of Knight and Lamb.
Knight throws it away. Strickland galloping to the basket. Luso and banged down. Henson. And that gets them off their feet here in Chapel Hill. 21-17. Kentucky. Lamb. Baseline runner. And banks it in.
He's showing us everything, Gus. Three-point catch and shoot off the dribble, under duress. He's perfect.
He's from Queens. You know he can get to the bucket. New York City. Under 10 to go, 23-17. Zella had it knocked away. Lamb again, poked away, gets it back to the rack. Uh-oh.
Showtime. But that's because of an errant pass, Gus. And I watched North Carolina practice yesterday. One of the things that leads to a lot of their turnovers is poor passing angles and telegraphing passes. You have to handle that ball with two hands. Pump fake, show misdirection. Here we take a look at a transition opportunity. The initial thrust doesn't go, but there's John Henson coming at you from another angle. Strickland overshoots it, but there's Henson chasing down that missed shot. And that's another reason that you run. Because even if you don't get that initial shot to go down, because the defense is in transition and not matched up, you can get to that offensive rank, offensive glass.
Henson with the extra pivot. And his mid-range game flourishing. 8 points for Henson. 25-19. North Carolina, they have the advantage inside with Henson and Zeller.
But you got to take care of the ball, Gus. A couple of the turnovers have led to easy scores for Kentucky.
Blocked by Henson. Strickland. Tar Heels are right back in it. 9:04 to play in the first half. College basketball, 30 years on CBS, and we've got a good one. 25-21. Let's reset the floor for you. A lot of young players on the court.
Only two juniors between, well, three juniors. Well, we got four. I keep adding them up. But a lot of freshmen and sophomores out there as well. But young teams. Kentucky reloading after losing five starters last year. Patrick Patterson, DeMarcus Cousins, John Wall, Eric Bledsoe. Actually, they lost four of the five. Darius Miller, the lone returning starter.
Jones blocked again by Henson. That's his third block. Jones having some problems. Drew, the kick, Barnes, pure. 25-24, Kentucky. Here come the Tar Heels, though. Knight the other way, contested by Zeller. The bigs playing well. Strickland, Barnes. Drew. Oh! Barnes with the tip jam. That's what they brought him here for. 9-0 run for Carolina.
Wow.
26-25, Tar Heel. Jones on the baseline. Let's see if he can make the adjustment. Henson has had his number. He lost it, and they're going to say it was tripped. But that's an interesting matchup for this game. Jones against Henson and Zeller. He's given up a lot of height.
And basically he's tried to play with his back to the basket and hasn't stepped away to try to put more pressure on Henson. A shot blocker loves to be able to hone in on an offensive player with his, when he has his back to him. It gives the defender an advantage. I think Terrence Jones has to step away a little bit and turn and face and try to use that jump shot and his ball handling ability.
And Liggins, the veteran on this team, knocks down a 20-foot jump shot. 27-26, Kentucky. 7:40 to play, first half. Henson posts it to the bucket. Blocked by Jones that time. Mm-hmm. He wanted a call, won't get it. Liggins, and he'll get a call. That's a block against Barnes, the freshman. To play in the first half. Starting to get warm here in Chapel Hill. 1-point game. All right, welcome back. Let's take a look at the game summary.
Well, you take a look at North Carolina, 11 of 21. They've assisted on 8 of their made field goals. 3-point shooting advantage, Kentucky. Turnovers a problem all year long for Carolina. Continues to be so here because when they're in transition, Gus, they're getting good looks. They've missed some high-quality open shots that they've got to be able to knock down. Kentucky doing it more on the strength of Lamb off the dribble and Brandon Knight off the dribble.
Roy Williams, 6-5 versus Kentucky. John Calipari. And Liggins at the line. Liggins recruited to Kentucky by Billy Gillespie out of Chicago. And he's really improve on the little things in his game.
That's a great point, Gus. So oftentimes, that's where you make the most progress when you pay attention to the little details. I like to say the plain things are the main things. And sometimes with young players, it takes them a while to understand that.
Inside, hits it again, almost threw it away. Tell you what, Clark, this Henson kid.
He's been impressive,
man. He's a special-looking player.
He sure is. Active, long, good timing, good hands, playing with a good motor. Well, he's put his imprint on this game in a big way here in the first 12 minutes.
Three blocks already. Zeller, nice catch. Had it knocked away, gets it back.
Got to be more decisive in there. You have to be more decisive in there. He's going to get bailed out with the foul. But when you catch it and you know that you're going to be double or triple team, you got to go immediately to your move or immediately to the kick out. You can't afford to put it on the floor, and you got to be strong and chin that ball in there and be decisive in your move.
Marshall comes back in for North Carolina, as well as Reggie Bullock. Another impressive All-America high school player with the ball now. They swing it, Strickland, Zeller calling for it. Zeller really working hard, trying to get Jones on his back. Henson. To Bullock. Henson keeping it alive. Zeller, tough rebound, blocked from behind by Jones, out of bounds, and Kentucky gets it again. John Calipari told his team yesterday that he felt that they could be physical with young Carolina. They could bully him a little bit, but so far, Zeller and Henson have been the bullies.
They've been doing work inside, and they've missed a number of good opportunities, both inside and on the edges. And if you're going to beat a ranked team, a team as good as Kentucky on your floor, you've got to convert those good scoring opportunities.
Jones, Knight, Jones to the basket.
You like that? See what happened? Faced him 17 feet away from the goal. It's a different game out there. And that was also Tyler Zeller defending him as opposed to John Henson.
And that's a big adjustment for John Calipari. Got a sports fan on your gift list? CBSSports.com shop is officially licensed NCAA gear from over 500 schools. And get 3-day shipping on every order. Go to shop.cbsports.com. 29-26. Kentucky, Wildcats have led by as many as 8. Carolina by as many as 3.
Already Carolina over the limit, so Kentucky shoots free throws the rest of the way on common fouls.
McDonald off the heel, Henson with a rebound, a jump shot inside, and he fakes it in.
He deserves that one. The effort he put into retrieving that loose ball, he's playing with a sprained right thumb, and that affected his shot. I don't think he was trying to bank it, but he got the result he needed, and he is glass-eating big time.
Zeller in the corner. McDonald driving. And a foul. This will be against Kentucky. McDonald aggressive to the basket after missing that last jump shot.
Well, he passed up an open three, I thought, but because the defender was under the basket, he was able to earn the trip to the foul line. That will always be called a block when that defender is underneath the basket trying to take a charge.
So Brandon Knight picked up his first. Les McDonald, sophomore from Memphis. All-time leading scorer in Memphis private school history. As he misses the first, he scored over 2,300 points. Also grabbed 875 rebounds. He's 6'4", he's strong.
Yep. And he's fast. Has struggled with his perimeter shot, though, as has Larry Drew. Drew, 22%. Strickland has made 47% of his shots, but a lot of those have been drives that he's completed.
He's a 57% free throw shooter. Splits him, but ties it at 29. 5:38 to play in the first half. Liggins.
They want to try to penetrate and get in the paint. Tough shot.
Not a good shot.
It was not. You're right. A challenge jump shot off the dribble when you haven't really moved the defense effectively.
And don't forget, we've got a great game coming up for you next. the number one team in the country. Undefeated Auburn battles South Carolina in the SEC Championship on CBS, presented by Dr. Pepper. If Auburn wins, they battle for the national title, but it won't be easy. It will not be easy.
They got the old ball coach in South Carolina. Man. He's had a couple of weeks, hasn't he?
Yes, he has.
Try to get a game plan together, but that Cam Newton is something special. Sometimes in these championship games, Gus, it comes down to who has the best playmaker. I don't know if there's anybody better than Newton.
Newton is good. First time they played, 35-27. Auburn won the game. Cam Newton rushed for three touchdowns, passed for two. Watts off the back rim, batted out by Zeller. Liggins, right place, right time. Six ties, five lead changes in this game. Jones, eight-footer, pure.
And you know that after the last timeout, John Calipari told Terrence Jones, operate a little farther away from the basket, facing, and see if they can defend you effectively then. When you're looking at him and you've got your full dribble alive, he can go off the dribble, he can shoot the three. He's got two good opportunities because he started to operate outside of the paint area.
Lamb.
Look at the spacing here. Dribble drive. They want a piece of that paint.
Block. Picked up. Vargas, and he traveled. The North Carolina bigs, it's almost as if they need to have a conversation with their guards. You got to get it to me. Let me touch it a little bit.
Well, part of that is the guards, because the bigs are so active and have been effective, the guards are getting good opportunities when they take care of the ball. They've been a little sloppy, sometimes a little late with the passes. But basically, I think they've done a good job. They've had a number of quality shots, Gus, against a good defensive team. You're not always going to be able to just throw it inside. The key is to make sure you get good shots. And Carolina has been able to get good shots when they haven't piddled the ball away. They just haven't made enough of them. And yet they're only down one.
Barnes will go to the free throw line. He's fouled by Vargas. So that means Vargas has three fouls, and Harrelson has two fouls.
That's the two-headed center that John Calipari uses, and in foul trouble, so Kentucky may have to go small a lot the rest of the way, as Harrelson is going to come back on the floor with the two fouls.
Let's see if North Carolina recognizes it when they get the ball back and try to go at it.
Yeah, that's a good point. They have to defend first. Harrelson, an excellent offensive rebounder, a big body that he uses effectively to help his teammates find lanes on the offensive end. Boy, this guy's been dominant, John Henson. Harrison Barnes has been terrific as well.
32-31, after being down by as many as eight, Carolina coming back to take the lead. They double-team Knight. Deflected out of bounds by McDonald. And coaches love deflection.
All the time. Disrupting the offensive flow of the opponent. It's a little thing, but it can be a big thing. That deflection leads to you having a chance now to reset your defense. And you used a little time on the shot clock, 22 left.
Henson and Zeller both back in the game, and Liggins wisely calls a timeout. And John Calipari is about to jump out of his Gucci loafers. He is not happy.
You take a look at the AP top 10, and I'm all for polls, but I think we shouldn't have an official poll until at least December 1. That way you've seen 7, 8, maybe 9 games teams have played, and you're basing it on what you've seen versus what you might expect. UConn, unranked in the preseason, now is in the top 10, Syracuse there, Missouri. But I think we do ourselves a service, a good service, to have a poll after you've watched teams play at least half a dozen games. So at the very earliest, December 1, I wouldn't even mind pushing the poll back, an official poll back.
For January.
January 1st. Sure, yeah, it'd be great.
You've been saying that for a long time.
Yeah, see.
Many, many years.
Yeah, I have. Just a personal observation. I mean, I think it would just give the poll more credibility, and you would be basing it on stuff you've seen versus what you're anticipating.
Jones off the mark with the free throw. Zeller with the rebound. Marshall in transition. Zeller fired. And rattled it home.
I love that trailing big guy that can stick the open jump shot, because you know the other big guys don't want to come out there and guard him, so you push the ball up strong, Gus, get that defense compressed, and then you got a seven-footer that has a stroke like that, and you take advantage of it.
Zeller got a lot of experience over the summer playing in Las Vegas with the U.S. select team, Knight, and he answers.
You can't leave him. You can't rotate off him.
Zeller, oh! North Carolina catching Kentucky sleeping. And the big fella got up and down.
My, was that impressive. That's one of the things Roy Williams has been trying to get his team to do all season, Gus. Score after the other team scores.
Watch out, Henson. North Carolina playing with swagger, having fun. After struggling to start this season, it looks like they found their mojo here in the first half.
They've been playing with tremendous intensity and passion, and the catalyst has been this guy here, number 31. John Henson has been fantastic.
Liggins, blocked by Zeller, picked up by Marshall. Carolina running again. The kick, McDonald. To play the first half. They are balling at Chapel Hill, folks.
Time to take a look at our AT&T analysis. We talked about playing with force. One way you look at it is from a free throw standpoint. Carolina plus one, plus two in free throws made and attempted, but they're also plus 10 in reboundings. And rebounding, another element of playing with force. Perimeter shooting, only one of six from the three-point line, and they've gotten some good looks. Squeezing the pumpkin, pretty good here for North Carolina. They average 17 turnovers a game. We've got just under 3 minutes to go in the first half. They can keep that number at six, maybe no more than seven. That'll be a good half for them turnover-wise. Josh Harrelson just picked up his third foul. So that's a problem, not just for the next 3 minutes, but going into the second half. A Kentucky team that's not very big and not very deep has a couple of guys with three fouls. Eloy Vargas and Josh Harrelson, both with three personal fouls now.
So now Kentucky has to go small. They bring in the game Darius Miller, as Harrelson sits on the bench with three. Zeller gets the second free throw. Carolina up 39-34. How do you attack North Carolina now when you have a size deficiency?
You've got to space the floor, and you've got to be ready to swing the ball and drive it effectively and pitch it out for good open shots. Get the big guy, Tyler Zeller, and Henson as best you can away from the basket.
Jones banks it in. Jones, so versatile. He can play with his back to the basket, Clark, and step out.
Yeah, he's got a lot in his pocket.
Knocked away, loose, picked up, Lamb, three on two. The kick, Knight, rise of fire.
That's where they can really hurt you. Just like that, five straight points for Kentucky. Two turnovers now, back to back for North Carolina. That brings their total to eight.
And coming up on AT&T at the half, it's a football-basketball combo. Timmy B and crew in Atlanta will preview the SEC championship game between number one Auburn and the old ball coach, Steve Spurrier, South Carolina squad. Auburn is trying to make it to the BCS championship game. We'll update you on what's going on in college basketball. Also, Clark and I will have a preview of what to look for this season. Jones again, and two-hand jam.
That's what happens when he steps away from the goal. His ball skills are terrific. The floor is spaced. Show the ball, get up under it. He can finish with force, as he just shows you right there.
Marshall throws it away again. Terrence Jones, for a freshman. What a cerebral basketball player.
Well, he's got some cerebral guys on that bench helping him see the game, too. In John Calipari,
Rod,
Kenny Payne, Rod Strickland, Orlando Antigua. I mean, those guys, they recognize the matchup advantage. And Roy Williams thought they would have a difficult time defending a guy like Jones, a guy like Knight and Lamb. And now we're seeing Kentucky exploit those individual matchup advantages.
Drew, diagonal pass, Strickland.
Carolina's had three empty possessions, Gus, in a row. Three straight turnovers. Need a good shot here.
Bullock. Rebounded by Darius Miller. With Knight looking over at Coach Calipari. Jones has been great stepping out on Zeller from about 12 feet away, rather. Now backs him down. Leans in. Blocked by Zeller. Third block of the day. Bullock. And he's fouled.
Good aggressive take that time by Reggie Bullock. In transition, there are driving seams available. Boy, and that was really close to a pretty good job defensively by Liggins. He got squared up, but may not have been there in time.
So Reggie from Kinston, North Carolina, first team parade All-America as well, 2010, Associated Press Player of the Year for the state of North Carolina, also the Gatorade Player of the Year.
Had knee surgery during his senior year in high school, Gus, and is still recovering from that, not 100%, but you can see he showed tremendous promise, a nice stroke, good activity and athleticism. Just takes a while when you're coming off an injury to get all of your game back.
27 seconds remaining in the first half, about a 4-second differential between the game clock and the shot clock.
Well, here you want to defend without fouling if you're North Carolina. Both teams over the limit.
Knight runs a pick and roll. Jones steps out. Now off the dribble. Forces his way to the basket and draws contact.
He is a tough, tough matchup, Gus. Early on, he was forcing it, playing with his back to the basket. He gave the advantage to Henson, the shot blocker for North Carolina. The last 7 minutes or so, he stepped away. And with his quickness and his ball skills, his shooting ability, he's figured out a way to get himself on the board. But his free throw shooting, for a guy with that kind of a stroke and rotation, it's mind-boggling that he's not made. Has he made any here in this game? Free throws?
Jones from the free throw line is 0 for 3.
Yes. But I think it's just concentration. And sometimes in the heat of a game, your adrenaline gets running, and you try to slow down, but you don't quite know how. That's when breathing and relaxing and really being able to concentrate in that manner can take some of the edge off your shot. There you go.
55% free throw shooter on the season. Came in this game 29 to 52. So with 8.4 remaining in the first half, Kentucky up by two. Here comes Carolina. Drew's going to have to hurry up. Over the line, Drew, baseline, Henson. They get it away, and short. And that's the end of the first half. Nine ties, eight lead changes. 42 to 40, Kentucky with the lead on the road. And we'll send you to Timmy B and company in Atlanta with AT&T at the half after this message and a word from your local station.
CBS Sports presents AT&T at the half. AT&T, the nation's fastest mobile broadband network.
Oh, you can feel the buzz here in Atlanta for an SEC championship game with so many storylines in play. For number one Auburn, a chance to clinch the conference and earn a shot at the BCS national title. And for number 19 South Carolina, the opportunity to make a debut fans won't soon forget. Hello, everybody, and welcome to AT&T at the half from the Georgia Dome in Atlanta. I'm Tim Brando, along with my friends Archie Manning, Spencer Tillman, and Tony Barnhart. Throw out the number one and 19 rankings because this is a rematch. And South Carolina's Steve Spurrier has been on this big stage more than a few times. I think this may well set up for an upset. But let's not forget Auburn's Heisman frontrunner Cam Newton, who on Wednesday was declared eligible by the NCAA and for the moment is free and clear of any suspicion of recruiting violations. What happened this week, Tony?
Guys, remember a couple of weeks ago I told you there would come a time in this investigation when the NCAA would have something to share with Auburn. Well, that time came on Monday. What the NCAA had was three things. Number one, one, that the father, Cecil Newton, engaged in conversations about play for pay. Number two, that Cameron Newton, the son, knew nothing about it. And number three, that Auburn had no knowledge of these conversations and did not participate in any way. Based on that, Auburn declared Cameron Newton ineligible on Tuesday, petitioned the NCAA for reinstatement. That reinstatement was granted on Wednesday, so he's free and clear to play. Guys, it's a controversial decision, but in my mind, it was the right decision.
All right, Tony, so what's next?
What's next is this is not over yet. People have asked me, is this over? It's not over until the enforcement staff completes their investigation. There can always be new information uncovered. We will have an end to this at some point, but it's not over now.
All right. Let's turn our focus back to the game. Auburn won the first meeting between these teams back on September 25th when South Carolina really let the game slip away due to sloppy play down the stretch. Does either team have an advantage in this rematch, Spencer?
Gentlemen, I think rematch advantages in this era of spread offenses is terribly overrated. It's about playmaking, and there's no bigger playmaker on this football field than Cam Newton. It's about becoming, defensively anyway, islands of excellence, how well you will perform in man coverage scenarios. If you can stand up under that pressure, you will have a good day. Now, the defensive coordinator, Ellis Johnson for South Carolina, may have a wrinkle or two scheme-wise, guys, but this is not so much about scheme as much as it is about skill at the end of the day, Arch.
And we all know Coach Spurrier has been a little frustrated with his quarterback as he has the last couple of years. Yeah. There's been some off-field problems. There's been some work habit problems, turnover. You might say bonehead plays. He's a different quarterback in 2010, though. His completion percentage is up 10%. He has 145 less passing attempts, but almost as much yardage. I think we can safely say Steve Spurrier has finally transformed Stephen Garcia into a real good college quarterback.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Well, got a sports fan on your gift list? CBSSports.com shop has officially licensed NCAA gear from more than 500 schools and get three-day shipping on every order. Go to shop.cbssports.com. And be sure to join us at 3 o'clock Eastern for CBS College Football Championship Saturday, presented by Ram, followed by TIAA Crep College Football Today. We'll tell you how the Cam Newton drama has united the Auburn team and also look at South Carolina's freshman phenom, Marcus Lattimore. Then at 4 Eastern, it's the SEC Championship game presented by Dr. Pepper, number one Auburn and South Carolina. We'll see you later, but up next, Gus and Clark will be back to update you on all of today's basketball action as AT&T at the half rolls on from Atlanta and Chapel Hill.
Welcome back to the Dean Dome. Really competitive first half. Kentucky, the 10th-ranked team in the country, with a two-point lead over the North Carolina Tar Heels. Gus Johnson along with Clark Kellogg, and a lot going on in college basketball this afternoon. So let's take a look at some scores from around the nation. And we'll start with the Georgetown Hoyas on top of Utah State. Hoyas ranked 16th, 58-43 right now. They're undefeated at 7-0.
And an outstanding threesome in Chris Wright, Austin Freeman, and Jason Clark. Three outstanding backcourt players.
Meanwhile, Wake Forest in Winston-Salem, 3 points better than Holy Cross. The Crusaders off to a tough start, 0-5 on the season. And the Cowboys of Oklahoma State at LaSalle in Philly, 21-18. Oklahoma State, how about Louisville?
Yeah, no, I tell you what, unbeaten, and looks like they'll continue to be unbeaten. Looking forward to seeing them the end of the month and checking out that fabulous new Yum Center.
That's right, they'll take on Kentucky in Louisville. Tommy Amaker, former head coach at Michigan, takes his Harvard Crimson Tide into Ann Arbor, and right now he's beating John Beilein's team 22-17 in the first half. Well, today is our season opener for college basketball, but I don't think it will be premature to start talking about what's going to happen in 4 months, which is the Final Four.
That's right. That's right. We're on the road to the Final Four. We start today, and we're going to take a look at some teams that may very well lift off to Houston, if you will. Let's go with last year's champions, the Blue Devils. This year's version certainly off to a really strong start and has a chance to perhaps win another NCAA title. Kansas, well coached, deep, athletic, balanced, and in Marcus Morris has one of the toughest, most difficult frontline guys to match up with. Tom Izzo has been to the Final Four in six of the last 12 seasons with the Michigan State Spartans. They've got a nice blend of experience, size, and talent, led by Kalen Lucas. And I'm objectively biased here, but the alma mater, the Ohio State Buckeyes. Jared Sullinger, an outstanding freshman, joins a returning cast of high-quality veterans. And the Pitt Panthers, under Jamie Dixon's leadership, this team, Ashton Gibbs is their leading scorer, but Wanamaker having a terrific start to his season, and athleticism and depth for the Panthers. And some other folks to keep an eye on, some contenders, if you will. Kemba Walker leading UConn. We talked about Georgetown, Lace Darius Dunn and Baylor, and then Washington, Lorenzo Romar's Huskies. Keep an eye on them, folks. And some other teams to just put on your isolated camera, if you will. Memphis, Richmond, led by Kevin Anderson. San Diego State, Steve Fisher has an outstanding, unselfish, very good defensive ball club. And Jim Boeheim, Syracuse, always lurking to make a surprise run.
Also, be careful of the Minnesota Golden Gophers. Tubby's got them going early, 42-40.
CBS Sports presents AT&T at the Half. AT&T, the nation's fastest mobile broadband network. CBS Sports College basketball coverage is sponsored by Skechers Fitness Footwear. Get more out of your workout. Sears, be the Santa you want to be. Find your Santa at sears.com/Santa. And by the Hartford. With the Hartford behind you, achieve what's ahead of you.
Kentucky leads North Carolina at halftime. Let's take a look at the State Farm first half stats.
Well, you take a look at the turnovers. That's a major problem for North Carolina. They're winning the free throw game, winning the rebounding game, three-point shooting, a huge advantage for Kentucky as they've been able to knock down 5 of 9. Carolina leaving a lot of cheese at that foul line, Gus, and the turnovers. Kentucky has turned those turnovers into 15 points. So a third of Kentucky's points, a little more than a third, have come off of Carolina's turnover.
North Carolina with the ball to start the second half. Barnes frees himself, comes up short with the jump shot, and it goes out of bounds. Harrison Barnes played 11 minutes in the first half, had 12 points off 4 of 5 shooting.
Had 2 personal fouls, and that's why he sat the time that he did.
Harrelson playing with 3 fouls. Knight, quick release. Zeller with the rebound.
I think Carolina has to continue to really try to push in transition. I thought they were most effective in transition, whether it was the trailing 3 or the trailing perimeter shot, which we saw a couple of times from Zeller, or just being able to get into the paint and get something high quality. Kentucky, on the other hand, was effective when Jones faced his defenders from 17 feet and in, as opposed to trying to play with his back to the basket as he did there. And again, he gives Hinton, a shot blocker, a chance to really hone in on what he's trying to do offensively. That's his third block.
Zeller also has 3 blocks.
Well, they've really dominated things around the basket, Zeller and Hinton for North Carolina. They've been the more physically aggressive and active team in the paint area.
Jones now puts it on the floor, has it knocked out of his hand as Strickland collapsed on the basketball.
Yeah, did a nice job there. You typically want to go to attack a post player on the dribble. 2 seconds to shoot here for Kentucky. That's time enough to make a pass and even 1 dribble, but no more than that.
Liggins, the Knight, has to hurry. And the rebound goes to Henson. That's his 9th rebound to go along with 12 points. Carolina with the chance to take the lead. We had 10 ties and 8 lead changes in the first half. Henson, 20-footer, Zeller again. Liggins. Nice look, Harrelson, and he banks it in.
Well done, beautifully done. Harrelson with a nice catch and finish, but Liggins keeping that dribble alive, Gus, until he forced that last line of defense to react to him with the ball.
Drew around the corner and a foul. Now, next Saturday, St. Louis collides with the number one team in the country and the defending national champ, Duke.
Duke has won something like 80 straight non-conference games at Cameron Indoor Stadium, a tall task for the Rich Majerus-led Billikens.
Is it hard for you to crawl through that?
I make my way, man. I do
alcove up top.
I do what's necessary. It is a little tight, but we make it work. It's actually a good place to watch a game in terms of seeing things develop from a bird's eye view. But the quarters are a bit cramped, no doubt.
44-42. Henson now draws a double.
Zeller! How about John Henson today, Gus? How about John Henson? This young fella is showing us everything.
He is showing off.
He sure is.
44.
Man, what a pass.
Miller, three-pointer. Got it.
That's what they've hurt. They've hurt Carolina there all game long, whether in transition. That time, just a little pick and pop. It's a tough cover for a big guy to try to get out there to a shooter. Well executed by Kentucky.
47-44. Strickland comes out. Kentucky doing a good job from the three-point line. They're 6 of 12. Liggins. Now Drew. Strickland wants it. Drew doesn't give it to him.
Strickland didn't have much room to operate if he would have gotten it.
Henson on the baseline at a five.
This is terrific work between the two big guys for Carolina. There you see Harrelson coming over. The rotation down low by Liggins late. Actually, Harrelson may have left too early to try to double team. And then went and didn't quite get his hands up. That's excellent recognition by Henson.
John Henson, only a sophomore. Liggins picked up his third from Tampa. A little short on that free throw. He's a 33% free throw shooter. Liggins heading to the bench. Well, there are some things to work on, but he's only a sophomore. 16:55 to play in the second half, 47-44, Kentucky.
That's painful to watch there, partner.
Harrelson, he came to Kentucky as a shooter. More of a banger now. Knocked away, Drew, straight to the basket, and lays it in.
Just great anticipation that time by Larry Drew II. That's a scouting report steal. He knew exactly what they were looking to do, and the Kentucky ball handler assumed that it was going to be there when it wasn't.
Jones posted. Knocked away. Drew. He's got Barnes with him. Drew splits the D and lays it in. Make that. Strickland. Miller spinning inside. 14-foot runner halfway down, pops out. Hits it with the rebound. Now it's Drew. And he lost it out of bounds. 10 turnovers for North Carolina. 15:30 to play in the second half. 48-47. UNC. Let's take a look at the AP preseason All-America.
Well, you see Harrison Barnes, the only freshman there, and a bit unfair and really unrealistic in my mind. It's hard to have a freshman on that preseason team when he hasn't played in college yet. There have been exceptions to guys being able to handle that, but as a general rule, you probably should refrain from having freshmen. Now, if you want to have a midseason All-America, team, then at that point, any freshman that's shown their worth, it makes a lot more sense then. But preseason, that's stretching things a bit.
48-47, Carolina. Jones cut off on the baseline, 19. And Zeller goes up high for the rebound.
One and done for Kentucky. Carolina doing an outstanding job on the defensive glass.
Drew along with Henson. Barnes. Drew to the basket. Double clutch. No. Tapped up and in by Zeller.
Well, these big guys have been outstanding. As a matter of fact, I think Carolina has to force feed the big guys. You talked about it in the first half, Gus. In the half court, they need to really concentrate on trying to get that ball to Zeller and Henson.
Guard's got to get it to him tomorrow in 60 minutes. CEO Mark Zuckerberg has a lot to say about Facebook, and he's saying it on 60 Minutes, a rare and revealing interview. That's 60 Minutes here on CBS, 50-47. North Carolina trail by as many as 8 in the first half.
And they're all excited and up in arms, but really no backcourt in that kind of situation. You can go all the way to the backcourt to get the ball on a baseline pass.
So Jones misses the jump shot, but Lamb, right place, right time. He knocks it down, ties the game up at 50. And a foul. Strickland will go to the line. You look at Strickland and you look at Drew. Not to be overcritical, but sometimes you look at guards that you're watching the two big guys, Zeller and Henson, just have great games, and they're having a hard time getting touches.
Yeah, they need to get more. I agree with you now. I mean, especially in the half court, Gus. In the half court, when you don't have something good right away in transition, then set it up and try to make sure your big guys touch it and play through them more. Right now, it's a matter of North Carolina's inside activity and free throw advantage versus the three-point shooting of Kentucky. I mean, that's really what we've got here. Kentucky has been very proficient from the three-point line. And North Carolina has gotten plenty of opportunities at the foul line, but he's not shot a high percentage there, and they've dominated the glass.
Terrence Jones picked up the second. He's on the bench now. And the Wildcats throw it away. That's over and back.
Good pressure by Strickland that time defensively. And just an assumption pass by Brandon Knight. Kentucky only averaging 12 turnovers a game coming into this afternoon's contest. And kind of right on pace for that number. They do a good job of taking care of the ball.
Barnes puts the defense to the basket. And the rebound goes to Darius Miller. Kentucky quickly into the front court. Lamb has been awesome. Curls down the lane. Kicks it out. Miller rises and rattles.
They get a touch of the paint on penetration, Gus. They force help and kick it out to an open shooter.
Miller with three threes. Lamb making that play possible. And Kentucky takes a 53-51 lead. Zeller, jump hook, rims off. Lamb with a rebound. Strong to the basket. Blocked by Zeller out of bounds. You see how he got up and down?
He can really run. He can stretch those legs out and cover ground. Strickland bothers him underneath, and that gives Zeller time to get to the ball up top. But excellent work by Zeller. He's got five block shots now, and you see Carolina really doing a good job on the glass, defending the paint. Kentucky has hurt him with a three-point shot. An individual offense through Lamb, Brandon Knight, and Terrence Jones late in that first half.
Knight hits the corner hard to the bucket, and offense. Zeller sliding in and taking the charge.
Wow.
How important was it for Tyler to play with the U.S. Select team this summer?
It's huge in terms of confidence. Boy, and I tell you what, I think he may have gotten away with one there. It seemed as though he stepped into Brandon Knight. That looked to be a block from my angle. Zeller made a great effort to get there, but I don't think he did get there in time.
53-51. Knight picked up his third foul. 13 minutes to go. Zeller wants it. Got Harrelson on his back. Cross the leg, jump hook, off the heel. Liggins. And a whistle. Looks like a foul coming up on the pass against Kendall Marshall, the freshman, Dumfries, Virginia.
Boy, DeAndre Liggins, I've watched Kentucky play three or four times, Gus. And when he's on the right side with that right-hand dribble, he wants that step here every single time.
And now they're doing that Euro step thing.
Bro, that's what I mean. He's mastered it. But every now and then, you've got to recognize where the defender is. That time he got bailed out with the foul.
Liggins, so strong. Lamb, so poised to be a freshman.
Yeah, he's got a lot of game. You're right, the poise is impressive. Never seems to be in too much of a hurry.
Jones playing with two, back in the game. Liggins a three. Henson with the rebound. Bullock back in the game, knocked away, stolen by Liggins. Not a good pass by Marshall. Down low, Lamb up and in. Head up by Liggins to find his teammate running the lane. 55-51 Kentucky. Kentucky on an 8-1 run. McDonald, 20-footer. Lamb again with a rebound and the push.
Nice pass.
Miller down the lane, a teardrop.
That's beautifully done. And Roy Williams is going to have to take a timeout because Kentucky making the extra pass and converting at the end of it.
Coming up later today, the number one team in the country, undefeated Auburn, battle South Carolina in the SEC Championship game on CBS presented by Dr. Pepper. Not an easy game for Auburn at all when they played earlier this year. Auburn winning it 35-27 at Auburn. McDonald down the lane. He comes off the bench and knocks down a runner.
Big basket that time for Carolina out of the timeout. This guy with the ball, Deron Lamb, has been absolutely splendid, igniting a couple of key rallies, one in the first half and here over the last couple of minutes for Kentucky with his tremendous playmaking ability. Somebody grabbed the rim there. Yeah.
Basket interference goes against Kentucky. Harrelson had it at point-blank range.
Mm-hmm. I think Terrence Jones may have gotten the rim there in his effort to get the to put it back down. Yep, it was Jones who got the rim. Kentucky still plus four.
CBS Sports College basketball coverage is sponsored by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. And by Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
Carolina has done a terrific job around the basket area, particularly defensively, denying shot opportunities. Henson has a handful. Zeller getting into the action as well. Zeller actually has five block shots. Henson has three, and Carolina as a team with nine, but Kentucky leads by four because they've been able to knock down 8 of 19 from behind the arc. Carolina has only made 1 of 9. And Gus, I just don't know if Carolina can prevail in this one if they don't knock down some perimeter shots.
Baseline, Bullock. Rims off, Watts off the bench, and one! Justin Watts, the junior from Durham, plays about 12 minutes a game. Timely basket there.
Working that weak side glass, most shots missed. The rebound is opposite from where the shot was taken. And Watts has been extremely productive here in the early season and limited playing time, Gus. And he gives you a few points, 12 minutes a game, and shoots a pretty good percentage from the floor because he typically gets hustle points close to the basket.
North Carolina, though, as he has a free throw, 11 of 19 from the free throw line. So the Tar Heels will have to hit their shots down the stretch.
Agreed.
57-56, they rise to their feet here at the Dean Dome. Knight, guarded by Drew.
They're taking a long time to get into their offense here.
Lamb. Eight to shoot. Lamb on the other side, five to shoot. And a reach in five. One of the points of emphasis coming from the officials this year.
You can't put your hands on a guy with the ball. You can arm bar him a little bit, but you can't put an open hand on a dribbler. And you can't impact the player's rhythm, speed, quickness, or balance. If you do, it's a foul.
Knight, Lamb, three-pointer, and it's good. This kid is terrific.
He's outstanding, Gus. Playing with the poise that belies his years. I mean, this kid has come in and really been the catalyst for game-changing runs for Kentucky. One in the first half and here in the second half.
Willock trying to answer. Liggins kicks it out. Knight.
Nothing forced for Lamb. He's got a few assists, no turnovers, good shot selection, playing with good pace.
Lamb with 19 points. 60-56. Fans wanted the walk, they won't get it. Four to shoot. Knight, two to shoot. Let's it go. And ripped down by Bullock. Drew, in transition. Euro step up, and one! He may have learned that from his dad.
Whoever he learned it from, he put it to good use here. Putting pressure on the defense by pushing that ball ahead in transition. Under control. Vargas unable to move his feet. And that's an easy call for the official.
And that move that you saw from Drew is something that we've been seeing in the professional ranks. Guys like Manu Ginobili brought that from the European leagues to be able to step around the defender.
That's right. And if you only can do that if you've got good footwork and you take your time and recognize where the defender is. Major foul trouble here for a relatively lean Kentucky team.
Vargas with four. He goes to the bench.
Calipari has only played seven guys today. Only has 10 scholarship players available.
And he adds a free throw. 1-point game. 8:54 to go in the second half. Knight. Guarded by Drew. Liggins. Takes hits it off the dribble. High off the glass. No. Batted out. Loose ball. Who wants it? Harrelson digs it out.
I think Dexter Strickland should have been in there on that rebound. He was trying to leak out before his team had possession, and your guards have to be ready to come into that three-point lane, that three-point area and foul line extended area to get rebounds that are on the floor. Strickland was already trying to get out to half court, and as a result, Kentucky comes up with that loose ball.
New shot clock for Kentucky. Miller, straight away. Zeller kept it alive. Drew, outlet. Hanson to the bucket. And he missed it with the left hand. 60-59.
I think Hanson should be able to punch that one home.
Next year.
Yeah, you got a man monster that one.
Lamb has had the hot hand. He's got multiple gears when the ball is in his hand.
Mm-hmm. Nice change of pace. I'll tell you what, Carolina's defense really has been pretty good.
Lamb. Oh, they call a block.
Wow. Tough call there.
One official called it a charge, another one called it a block. The baseline official says block.
And I think he was right. Zeller moved into him.
Welcome back. 60-59 Kentucky, and a look at the game summary.
Well, three-point shooting, we've talked about it all game long. Kentucky really winning that battle. And a big reason for them winning that battle the way they are, Deron Lamb roaring like a lion with his play. Three-point shooting in transition, setting up other people, and doing it all under control and in timely fashion.
Lamb, 7 of 10 from the field, 3 of 4 from the three-point line, 2 of 2 from the free throw line, 3 assists, 1 steal, no turnover.
Stat sheet stuffer, can you say that?
Yes. As he adds a free throw, he went to legendary Oak Hill Academy from Queens, went to Oak Hill, and you know when you go to Oak Hill, they really teach you how to play the game.
Very impressed. You talk about he short arms that one, but you talk about having a nice weapon off the bench. Smart, tough, and very versatile.
Barnes down the lane, not a good shot, and it goes over the backboard and out of bounds.
A good strong drive, but you have to finish it with more strength. Kind of shot that one on the way down. Carolina just 3 of 11 after a pretty crisp start in this second half.
Harrelson.
Kentucky content to Gus to space the floor and be patient. Look at the spacing here. The lane is wide open. And they'll look to just dribble into that lane, get to the basket if possible. Really, they just want to force help and then pitch it to an open shooter.
Jones thinking about the three-pointer. Now to the basket. That one comes off his hands. Flat. Henson with a rebound. Drew poked away from behind. Out of bounds. And Carolina will hold on. Darius Miller checking in. Terrence Jones. It's been a struggle for Jones this afternoon. He's 3 of 15 from the field, 7 points. Here's a kid that averages 21 a game.
Well, I would think Carolina goes inside. They've got a matchup advantage on whoever
there it is.
Miller is guarding, because they've only got one big guy out there, Gus, and that's Harrelson. So one of the big guys for Carolina, Zeller or Henson, is going to be guarded by a much smaller player.
Great decision by Larry Jew. Ties the game up at 61. 13 ties, 10 lead changes. 6:27 to play. Lamb popping out on the wing. They look inside. Miller, and he's fouled. Great look by Brandon Knight.
Well, I like the way Kentucky has executed offensively, Gus. When they've needed to, that's a bullet pass right on the money by Brandon Knight. See, now, on the one hand, they give up some size in the defensive matchup, does Kentucky. But at the other end, one of the bigs for Kentucky has to play a perimeter guy. And Kentucky trying to take advantage of that by spacing the floor, and then just did a nice little slip there for Miller. Here comes Jones. You see Calipari probably do a little offense, defense substitution. But you know, with this lineup now, he's got 5 offensive players out there, and everybody can step away and put the ball on the floor. And you got Jones on the floor as the big.
Kentucky by 2. Strickland. They reverse it. Henson tried to feed the post, and it's kicked. Out of bounds. With 15 to shoot.
Both teams one foul away from being over the limit. 16 fouls committed both ways. So all of that stuff becomes really important in a tight game. 6 minutes to go.
Barnes in the corner. Let's it go.
Boy, he passed up the first shot, Gus. He passed up a good one. He should have turned into that shot. And then he takes a fourth challenge shot. That's just part of growing up, though, as a freshman, to understand how to get the best available shot. and not second.
Oh, Knight throws it out of bounds, trying to run the pick and roll with Darius Miller.
And John Calipari up to half court.
And he can't believe it.
I'm not sure exactly what his frustration is with the turnover, but I think he may have wanted Brandon Knight to keep that dribble alive and maybe turn the corner more aggressively as opposed to backing into a pass to a teammate that wasn't there.
'63-61. They lob it to Henson. And a whistle. Looks like this will go against Knight. Trying to keep Henson away from the basket. Knight picks up his fourth.
I think Knight did a pretty good job anticipating that lob. And he was whistled for getting underneath Henson, but Henson, who has struggled mightily from the line. This is the bonus, Gus. Brandon Knight will sit briefly here. Well, if you're North Carolina, if you're Zeller, you got to be thinking about offensive rebounding here. I mean,
let's see.
Henson has really struggled from the stripe all season.
Missed the front end. Liggett's back in the game for Knight. They move Lamb over to the point.
Yep.
Jones stops. High Archer, a brick. Out of bounds, and Carolina gets it again.
Defense. Did you see Zeller get over to help out Henson as well? Tough decision there by Terrence Jones. He indicates it's his fault. He took a challenge shot off the dribble early in the shot clock. You can get better than that, and he knows it.
Carolina needs a two to tie, a three to take the lead. Barnes working on the baseline. Zeller trying to keep it alive. Barnes now forcing things.
Yep.
He's not using his teammates.
Exactly. And a big-time rebound by Terrence Jones. He went in amongst traffic and came up with a huge ball.
Lamb.
Pick and roll action here, because you can pick and pop this guy.
Jones, oh, and Zeller called for the foul.
Yep, he slid into him. Slid into him, Gus.
Don't forget, later today, it's the SEC Championship. Cam Newton, maybe the best player in all of America, but watch out. Alshon Jeffrey from South Carolina, 75 catches, 1,351 yards. South Carolina also with Marcos Lattimore, freshman running back, 17 touchdowns, over 1,000 yards. Garcia, the quarterback, 18 touchdowns. And when they met earlier this year, a close game, 35-27. South Carolina fumbling the ball a couple of times early. Full coverage coming up right after this game. Kentucky, as Jones gets the free throw, 65-61. North Carolina stagnant. Last couple of possessions. Bullock curling. Nice look. Zeller. And foul. You got to keep this guy's hands full with this one.
I agree. I agree with you wholeheartedly. We've talked about it. In the half court, Carolina needs to play through their big guys, Zeller and Henson, and then trust them to make plays or make good decisions if they don't have their own shot.
John Calipari has a decision to make. Harrelson picked up his fourth. Vargas is on the bench with four. Now he's going to bring him in the game. As Zeller makes the first free throw. And earlier you were talking about his experience in Las Vegas with the U.S. Select team and how it's really helped Zeller become a better player.
Well, what it does is when you're around the best players in the world, you look at their preparation, attention to detail, all of the physical attributes they have, the way they get ready to play. And when you can compete in that environment, it helps to raise your confidence.
65-63. Closing in on 4 minutes to go in the second half. Carolina ratcheting up the defense now, and Kentucky's got a burn of timeout. 4:01 to go, second half. 65-63, Kentucky. A look at the game reset. North Carolina with three timeouts left. Kentucky with one, possession arrow in the favor of the Wildcats. Each team over the limit. 18 on the shot clock now for Kentucky.
Well, this is where execution is critically important. You want to get good shots or get yourself to the foul line. And Carolina wants to defend without fouling. And then if they can force a miss, I think it's important that they try to run in transition and get something early.
No field goals in the last 5:56 for Kentucky. Baseline, Jones, three to shoot across the lane. Short, great defense by Zeller. Here comes Strickland, hard push to the basket, drops it off Zeller, and he's fouled from behind.
Boy, Henson may have been, it seemed like he was flirting with the baseline when he caught that pass, and Jones trying to shake out the cobwebs. Strap it on, partner. We're headed to the finish line.
CBS Sports College basketball coverage is sponsored by State Farm. With 18,000 agents, we've got the best lineup in the game.
The game reset, 65-63, Kentucky, Carolina going to the free throw line. Tyler Zeller with the chance to tie this game up. And Zeller is a 69% free throw shooter. Well, got whacked in the mouth on that play, and he's a little cut up now.
Yeah, he is. He sure is. It's been a physical game out there, Gus. And Carolina has had the best of it on the glass and at the foul line, but they don't have a lead to show for it because they've missed nine foul shots, and they've not made any threes other than one.
First free throw good for Zeller. 4 of 5 from the line today for Tyler. He's got 20 points, 9 rebounds, 5 blocks. This went for the tie. And he gets it. 65 up. 3:38 to go, second half. Knight, Jones, Miller, Lamb, Liggins for Kentucky. Liggins has done a nice job finding his teammates on the wing. He picks up his dribble in no man's land. Knight locked it out of bounds. 11 turnovers for Kentucky. And they're going to get Harrelson back in the game.
55, Josh Harrelson.
And he goes to get Darius Miller. 65-65. 14 ties. 10 lead changes. Carolina is trailed by as many as 8. By as many as 6 in the second half and a 5. And that's going to go against Jones, and he's fouled out of the game. But he fouled the right player. Because Henson.
Well, he made a poor decision there to reach in and gamble that far away from the goal over the limit at this juncture in the game. But that's part of growing pains when you're a young team on the road in a hostile environment. Sometimes your thinkers get clogged. And now Kentucky doesn't have one of its, well, its leading scorer and one of its most potent offensive weapons, although he has struggled here today. He's still a weapon that you'd like to have because of his ability to shoot the ball and put it on the floor and take shot blockers away from the paint.
He finished with 9 points, 6 rebounds. Henson has struggled from the line. Not that time.
Look good.
2 air balls from the free throw line to John Henson. As he misses the second, taps around, Knight with the board. And a foul. Now they'll make the walk to the other end.
Going to call it on Tyler Zeller.
Tyler Zeller.
That's his fourth.
18 foul. Harrison Barnes checks in for time.
Harrison Barnes checks back in. Henson heads to the bench. What a game for Henson for North Carolina.
Brandon Knight.
12 points, 12 rebounds. Knight misses. Zeller with the board. 66-65. Under three to go. Carolina. Strickland crosses over to the bucket. Oh, stripped from behind. Out of bounds. That was a great play. Looks like Darius Miller may have got a hand on it.
I think you're right, Gus. Strong drive by Strickland, but Miller doesn't give up on it. And you can see his eyes tracing and tracking the ball. Excellent job by Darius Miller after he got beat on the drive.
23 to shoot. Let's see if Carolina goes to their bread and butter. Zeller. Harrelson is playing with 4 fouls. Zeller wants it. Bullock won't even look at it. 7 to shoot. Drew off the bounce to the bucket. No. Harrelson with the rebound. 66-65. 2:20 to go. Knight. And a foul.
Strickland guilty of holding. He was in excellent position. Got overzealous with the hand. Boy, not a good offensive possession that trip by North Carolina. But you have to understand that much time on the shot clock. Zeller has to be working to try to get it, and you got to be intentional about trying to throw it in there. You can't give casual looks to the post player in this. I mean, you got to be determined to figure out a way to try to throw it in there. And even just by doing that, Gus, you create passing angles, maybe away from Zeller.
Lamb gets the first to tie it at 66. He's got a career high. 21 points. He's 4-5 from the stripe for the lead. And he gets it. 67-66. Kentucky. Drew.
Carolina get a good shot or knock down an open perimeter shot.
Barnes. Lost the ball, taken away. Twelve turnovers for North Carolina. Lamb slices, jump hook. Zeller grabs it. Now let's see if they give him the basketball. And a timeout call by Coach Williams. 67-66, Kentucky, 1:36 to go. Second half, don't go away. Take a look at the game reset as Tyler Zeller comes back on the floor. Kentucky up by one. Zeller has 21 points, 11 rebounds. He's 8 of 13 from the field. The man guarding him, Harrelson, has 4 fouls. Both teams are over the limit, and it's almost as if this backcourt at North Carolina doesn't realize his stats.
Well, they called the timeout. Let's see if they can execute the call play.
Now Zeller posting up. Give it to him. There it is. Across the lane, and he's fouled.
Not complicated. And Roy Williams, since in the last couple of possessions prior to this one, that's why he called the timeout. He mandated that we get the ball to number 44. And sometimes with a young team and guards that seem to be thinking otherwise, you have to shock them back into attention mode.
And not only is he having a great game, he's 6 of 7 from the free throw line. One of the better free throw shooters on this team for the lead. Got it. 68-67. 1:20 to go, second half. Bedlam at the Dean Dome. Miller to Brandon Knight, the freshman, 1:06. Darius Miller drives, stops. Knight off the dribble, 15-foot runner, no. Harrelson with the rebound, takes it, and he lays it in. He took it away from Zeller.
second. Kentucky up by a point and a foul.
Harrelson's out. Zeller to the line.
What a terrific job by Harrelson here. Tough shot, good defense, and then it's a matter of just getting after the ball. And he hasn't been able to play a lot because of foul trouble, just DQ on that last play. But he showed you there what the Wildcats have missed in his absence due to the fouls. Just a guy who can get his body between other people and the ball. That was a good bit of officiating, too, not to anticipate a foul there, to just let it play out.
The officials in this game have been excellent. Roger Ayers, Mike Edes, and Jamie Lucky. It's been a very fluid game.
Yeah, it has had tremendous flow, excellent intensity. Now it comes down to playmaking and shot making, and that's what you like to see as a coach, as a player, as a fan.
69-68 Kentucky. There we go. Zeller with a career high of points and rebounds, and it shows on his face for the lead. He has been money. 70-69. 45 seconds to go. The opening game of college basketball on CBS, and we've got a thriller. Leggett. Knight. They want to isolate Lamb. He's being guarded by Strickland on the wing. 16 to shoot. Lamb. Baseline. Runner. No. Loose. Out of bounds. And North Carolina has it. Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
They just called the foul on Eloy Vargas. I think it may have happened even after the play, Gus. And that's his fifth foul, so he's been Dairy Queen. Let's take a look. Isolation, as you called it, for Lamb. That's not a bad shot, little runner. Tough one to make. Contact. And then I don't know what happened away from the ball. It was knocked out by Kentucky. And then Vargas was whistled for a foul. Here we go from another angle. Let's look. Keep an eye on Vargas, number 30. He sets the screen. Lamb rejects it. Contact there, no call. Oh, and then there's the body bump right there. So one official, Mike Eads, in the right bottom of our screen, indicated ball out to Carolina.
And this is the kind of game that Roy Williams needs. He needs to win this one, especially after the way they started the season. It could really catapult this team.
Well, in my conversation with him, before the game, Gus, he talked about needing a couple of breaks. I think the defense has been excellent all game long for Carolina, particularly in the half court. And even though they've not shot it well from the perimeter, you're right, Gus, this is the kind of win that can energize a young, developing team.
Larry Drew, 61% shooter. Gets both. Kentucky will set it up. They'll talk about it. 72-69, 20.9 to go. Back after this. A look at the game reset. Kentucky still with a timeout left, as well as Carolina. 72-69. What's the strategy here? Do you go for a three or do you go for a two?
You're a basketball guy. You know what I'm going to say. You go for the quick two here. Quick two. Plenty of time. You got just under 21 seconds. Quick two. You know the defense doesn't want a foul. They're going to be a little tentative. You expect them to be tentative, so aggressively attack the goal. Now, if upon attacking the lane is clogged, then you've got to make a basketball play and get it to the open guy. And if you have a good look at the three, I think you take it.
Kentucky's got to go the length of the floor. Knight.
But you're thinking hard, quick two. But taking the time they're taking, they're thinking three.
Knight drive. Fire. Got it.
Well done. They just cleared the side. When you got a player that can make get his own shot, isolated. Well done by Kentucky there. Very nice.
72-71, Carolina. The Coke Zero game reset. Kentucky out of timeouts. Both teams over the limit. North Carolina with one timeout remaining. What do you do here if you're Kentucky down by one, Carolina inbound?
A couple of schools of thought. You can foul right away. I say give yourself a couple of seconds to maybe force a turnover from a turnover-prone team in the backcourt. Pressure without fouling, and then foul within 2 or 3 seconds. But I'd say try to give yourself a chance to force the turnover.
Lamb almost coming up with it. Drew.
See, that's why I don't think you foul right away. Now you got him set up here, and this is where I would love to see a rule change to where you don't get a new 10 seconds here.
Reward the defense.
Yeah, exactly.
Barnes inbounding. He's a freshman. Looking. Zeller. That's who they wanted to have the ball.
Yeah, now you got a foul right away. Okay. Good execution both ways, I think. The one, the pull-up jumper by Knight, isolation. Took a little longer than I anticipated there, but nonetheless, they got a good shot. Got it to within one. Set their defense, almost forced a turnover. And now you put Zeller on the line, who's made his last four from the stripe, to have to make a couple more here.
Zeller, 9 of 10 from the free throw line. Now the next free throw off, big one. Lamb has hit three threes. And he gets it. No timeouts for Kentucky. Carolina makes a substitution. McDonald comes in. And now North Carolina will call a timeout. Great drama here at Chapel Hill. John Calipari will get a chance to draw one up. Roy Williams wants to defend it. Both teams out of timeouts. 10.3 to go. 74-71. Kentucky's got to go the length of the floor.
Too much time to foul here. I think you've got to just be solid defensively. Try not to open up the floor.
Knight has hit three threes. Hands it off at a foul. With 6.1 to go, that'll send Kentucky to the line.
I don't think that was an intentional foul. I think they were just trying to play pressure defense, and Strickland a little too tight to Lamb. But I like the strategy there. Tight pressure defense. Everybody at home. The floor was not open. Guys were assignment tough and ready. And now if you're Kentucky, you look to make both of these. No timeouts remaining, so North Carolina has to be ready to set solid screens and inbound if he makes both.
Zeller comes back in.
Justin Knox.
As well as Justin Knox. Barnes and McDonald check out. 6.1 remaining. One more for Lamb. And he gets a second. Kentucky needs a quick foul, and they get it. Strickland. And Dexter Strickland is a 68% free throw shooter. 5.6. A lot of time.
Plenty of time, Gus. Plenty of time. Now, if Strickland is able to make these, then I think you consider fouling if you're North Carolina. That 5 to 6 second range when you're up three is kind of the window that most coaches talk about. And I would, if I was
that's the great debate in college basketball.
It's one of them.
Basketball, period.
It's one of them, but the percentages are in your favor if you foul. I mean, I've seen statistical analysis of it. A lot has to go wrong for you to lose up three with 5 seconds or less if you foul.
But the dilemma is if you foul and the guy...
Well, you got to foul in the backcourt here. I mean, they can't advance the ball if the shots are made. Ooh. Now, we're jumping ahead of ourselves here, obviously. He's got to make a couple of free throws in order for the foul to be even in play.
So Strickland One of two from the line today. Shooting two. He was on the court first man yesterday for practice, working on his game. As the subs come in, Barnes.
Everybody has to know their assignment and know what the game plan is. I say keep the ball in front of you on the inbound, again, assuming the shot is made, and then foul on the catch in the backcourt.
Oh, he missed it. Lamb from half court. And that's it. North Carolina finally registering a signature win as they come back to beat 10th-ranked Kentucky 75-73.
Well, some seconds ticked off as that ball was fought for. Not a bad job here by Lamb. That was about the best he could do in that situation. Not much more could have been done. He was just a little wide left.
75-73, Carolina